There's no place like it. And our home is changing. Living in a world just 1 degree warmer has shown us that homes and buildings need to be more resilient in the face of extreme weather. But it's not enough to react to climate change. We need to act on climate now. How did we get here? Imagine Earth's history in a single day. Humans would show up less than a minute and a half before midnight. The Industrial Revolution brought innovations that changed the way we live. Electricity, factories, the railroad. Innovation changed humanity and the planet. In the 1820s, Joseph Fourier proposed Earth's atmosphere may act like the glass on a greenhouse. By 1856, Eunice Newton Foote had concluded that more CO2 in our atmosphere would increase temperatures. By the 1930s, scientists and others were connecting the dots between warmer temperatures and industry. 1965, a report delivered to U.S. President Lyndon B. Johnson predicted changes in climate. 1975, the term global warming is introduced to the public by American scientist Wallace Broecker. 1988 brought the hottest summer on record to date, and NASA scientist James Hansen testified to Congress that global warming was already here. In 1990, we emitted 32 billion tons of greenhouse gases globally. Today, we emit roughly 51 billion tons. That's 40% more. The IPCC estimates that limiting temperature increase to 1.5 degrees Celsius would require that we cut emissions in half by 2030 and reach net zero by 2050. To put it in perspective, a 1.5 degree increase means an ice-free Arctic once every 100 summers, while a 2 degree increase means 10 times that, an ice-free Arctic every 10 years. That half a degree difference would mean the end of coral reefs and double the loss of habitat for plants, insects, and other wildlife. The loss of biodiversity alone would have devastating ripple effects. The goal at this point is mitigation. The kind of sweeping collaboration, commitment, and innovation this will require is unprecedented. This success will not be possible without the leadership of the building industry, an industry with a massive responsibility and a profound opportunity tip the scales. We have a common goal, a livable planet, and a healthy future for everyone. So how do we get there? Every builder knows you need a plan, a blueprint. Our plan needs to be strategic and actionable. The built environment, the places where we live, learn, work, and gather, account for 39% of global greenhouse gas emissions. 11% of this is embodied carbon. 28% is operational carbon. To drive down these emissions, we need to build right. We need to build above code. And we need to adopt net zero building codes going forward. We need to build high-performing, energy-efficient buildings that last. We need to leverage the tools and technologies we already have. This means using more efficient lighting and more efficient heating and cooling systems. It means more green roofs, heat pumps, smart glass, smart thermostats, and of course, proper insulation, both for new builds and renovations. Just starting here will make a huge dent in operational carbon emissions while also making the most of our current energy sources. Going forward, we need these buildings and our job sites to be powered by renewable energy. To tackle embodied carbon, we need manufacturers to drive the innovation of scalable low carbon and carbon regenerative materials. We also need scalable bio-based raw materials that help lower embodied carbon. And wherever possible, we need to opt for retrofitting existing building stock over new builds, making good use of the embodied carbon already emitted. Our industry's commitment is critical, as the UN projects 2.5 trillion square feet of building space will be added over the next 40 years. This is the equivalent of building one New York City every month, in essence, doubling the number of buildings already on the planet. If we were to continue building as we have in the past, we'd be contributing to temperature increases of 4 to 8 degrees centigrade between now and the end of the century. But we are not continuing with business as usual. We are laying a new foundation, expanding our tools as we go, and adapting our plan as needed. We can't click our heels and make the threat of climate change disappear. We have to face it. And it won't be easy, but the alternative is devastating. And luckily, we are an industry that is not afraid of hard work. We are an industry facing the present with our eyes open. Ready to build the future? DuPont Performance Building Solutions and Corian Design, using building science to innovate as if our future, our home, depends on it. Because it does.